Hello everyone, welcome to MifraTech. Today in this section we'll learn about smart irrigation system project code explanation. So now I'm going to explain the exact programming part, what we have done it for the smart irrigation system project. So in order to do the programming, previously we had to install Arduino IDE software in your system. So we are going to provide you a folder that is named a smart irrigation system. So it will contain a Arduino programming file required for this project. So in order to run that project in Arduino IDE, there are two ways. Now I am going to show you both the ways. So first, you go to file manager, like wherever you have downloaded that particular folder. So after coming to this folder in your file manager, so the name of the folder will be smart irrigation system. So where you have, like in particular location where you have downloaded that folder, come to that location and click on this, open this folder, smart irrigation system. So now you open this folder. So whenever you open this folder, inside that the smart irrigation system, an Arduino file is present. So as you can see, type is Arduino file. So this file contains the exact program required for this project. So in order to run this, in order to open this programming file in Arduino IDE, what you have to do is just double click on this one. So whenever you double click on this this Arduino file, so the programming file will be opened in Arduino IDE that I will show you now. So as you can see, this is the smart irrigation Arduino programming file has opened in Arduino IDE. So this is the one way of opening this Arduino file. So there is another way. In order to do that, first you close this one. So after closing this one, you go to home page of your system or laptop, go to the search bar now. So after coming to search bar, so as you can see, I came to here search bar. So here you type Arduino. So as I told earlier itself, you have to previously install Arduino file required for this project. So here you type Arduino. So whenever you type Arduino, so it is installed in my system. So it is showing Arduino app. So you just open this Arduino app. So whenever you open this one, so this home window will open, as you can see here. Here there is a void setup, void loop, and there are different options here: file, edit, sketch tools. So in order to create a new sketch or in order to open the previously available Arduino, like Arduino programming file in your system, in order to open that, just click on file. So whenever you click on file, there are different options available: new, open. So just now, in order to open the previously available, like already available programming file in your system, so just click on open. So after this, this window will open. Here you should go to the particular directory wherever that smart irrigation system Arduino programming folder is present. So as you can see, now I came to this folder, smart irrigation system. So now we open this folder. Inside the smart irrigation system Arduino file is present. So in order to open that, just click on this and click on open. So now you click on open. So the smart irrigation system Arduino file is, programming file is opened in Arduino IDE. So as you can see here, this is the one way of opening this, second way of opening this Arduino programming file in Arduino IDE. So these are the two ways. Now I am going to explain you the programming part, what I have done in this program. So here we have to, as mainly in this project, we are using Arduino Nano microcontroller. So as you can see here, first we have to include those things now. So as you can see here, this is the required program for the smart irrigation system. So first, as you can see, ash into dst.h. What I have done is, smart irrigation project, I am using a DST11 temperature sensor in order to detect temperature and humidity values. So in order to read temperature and humidity values, we have to initially include this library. So I am including ash into dst.h header file I am including. Next, I am defining, so whatever the header file I have defined, after that, the whatever the pin number I have connected this DST11 temperature sensor, that we have to define. So as defined, DST11 underscore pin number 4, that is D4 of Arduino Nano, I connected here, digital pin. Next, we have to create an object of this library. So DST.DST of, we have to pass the pin number, DST underscore 11 pin. Next, we have to write the type of this DST11. So there will be two types, DST11 and DST22. So DST underscore 11 pin comma DST underscore 11 we are using temperature sensor, so that I have created. So next we have to if this ash into dst.h, what I have done, if this library is not available in this particular software Arduino IDE, means we should you can download it in any web browser. After that, you can include in this Arduino, particular Arduino software, whatever you're using. So for that, there is a procedure available. So you go through that video, and after that, you include this DHT11 if it is not available in your system. After that, you have to define all these things. So next, we'll define whatever the sensors or project we are used in this project to some variables. First, integer variable I'm creating. So int water. This is in order to. So in the smart irrigation system, we are using a water level sensor. So as it is analog sensor that I have connected to pin number A1. So as you can see, A1. So whatever the A1 I have connected, that I am storing in another variable here, integer variable water. So next, moisture sensor is also analog sensor that I have used in this project. So int moisture that I have connected to A0 of analog pin of this Arduino Nano microcontroller. So that I am showing in another variable moisture. Next, we have used a water pump here. So whatever the water pump I have used here, so that I connected to pin number 3, that is digital pin of Arduino Nano. So that I am defining here, int pump is equal to 3. So next, this is the initial requirement we have to do, whatever the libraries required and whatever the pin number we have assigned, that we are storing in some variables, or we can directly use these pin numbers in the program itself. So after that, in any Arduino programming, two important things is void setup and void loop. Inside the void setup, we have to do the setup. That is, we have to define the baud rate and we have to define the pin mode. Like whatever the components used in the particular project, whether we are using them as input device or output device, that we have to define in this void setup. Next, in the void loop, we have to write the exact programming logic required for that particular project. Now we will do the setup. So inside void setup of serial.begin 9600. Here I am setting the baud rate. Usually we use this 9600 baud rate. Next, as we are using DHT11 temperature sensor, that we have to begin here. So DHT.begin of. So next we'll define the pin mode. So pin mode of moisture comma input. So any all the sensor will used as the input only. So if the like LED, DC motors or buzzer, pump is there, means they are all output devices that we have to define as output. So as moisture sensor is an input device, so I am defining the pin mode of moisture comma input. Similarly, pin mode of water level sensor is also input. So pin mode of water comma input. Similarly, water pump is an output device, pump. So I am defining pin mode of pump comma output. So this is the required setup we have to do. Next, we'll write the logic in the void loop. So void loop of. So as I told, TST11 temperature sensor can read both temperature and humidity values. So we are reading both here. So in order to store that humidity value, I'm creating a floating variable, float h. So DHT.readHumidity will read the humidity value from this DHT11 temperature sensor. So that I am storing in a floating variable h. Similarly, we'll read the temperature. So DHT.readTemperature will read the temperature value. I'm storing in another floating variable t. So whatever the temperature and humidity I'm reading, that I'm printing in the serial monitor. So serial.print current humidity is equal to, as you can see, that I am printing in the current humidity. So it will be printed in the here. So serial.print of h I am printing. Similarly, serial.print of temperature. So temperature value also I am printing, serial.print of t. So serial monitor is, as you can see, there is a like a search like thing is available in the topmost serial monitor. This is the serial monitor. So all these datas will be displayed here. In the serial monitor. Similarly, serial.println of C. So as you can see, whatever the temperature it is read, it will be in Celsius. After that, 1000 millisecond of delay I am giving. So this is required in order to read temperature and humidity. I am printing whatever the output we are getting. We are seeing the output in the serial monitor of this in this Arduino IDE itself. So after that, we'll read the analog that water level sensor. So as analog water level sensor is analog sensor, I have connected to analog pin, we have to read using analog read only. So analog read of water, whatever the value read by this water level sensor, I am storing it in the another variable int VW, water level value. So that whatever the water that it is reading value, that I am directly printing in the serial monitor, serial.println of water level sensor values. So now I am checking, if of the water level sensor read value is less than 350, means water level is low. So I am printing that in the serial monitor, level is low and 200 millisecond delay I am giving. After that, I am turning off the pump. So whenever the water level is low, I should turn off the pump in order to provide the water supply. So I am making digital write of pump comma high. So this will turn on the water pump. So next, if of else if of water level value is less than greater than 350 means water level is high. So I am printing in the serial monitor, serial.println of level is high. Similarly, 200 millisecond delay I have given. Next, digital rate of pump is low. So whenever a water level is high, I should turn off the water pump. So I am making digital rate of pump comma low. So in this way, this water level sensor will automatically help in order to detect whether the water level is low, high, low or high. So whenever it is low, I should turn on the water pump in order to provide the water supply. Whenever it is high, I should turn off. Next, moisture sensor will do. So here, as moisture sensor is also an analog sensor, I have connected to analog pin. I am reading using analog read. So analog read of moisture. So whatever the value read by this moisture sensor, I am storing in integer variable int moist one. So now I am printing the moisture values, whatever it is reading. So serial dot println of moist one. We can see the output in the serial monitor. So after that, a 200 millisecond of delay I am giving. So now I am checking if the moist one, whatever the value read by this moisture sensor, it is less than 500 means moisture is high. If it is low means moisture is high. Else if of moisture is greater than 500 means I am printing moisture is low. So in this way, depending on whatever the moisture value read by this, I am printing whether it is moisture is high or low. So this is the required logic for this smart irrigation system project. So now we have to compile this program and then we have to upload it to the Arduino Nano microcontroller. So in order to compile this one, what you have to do is just you have to click on you click on tools here. That I will show you now how to compile. So now, as you can see, whenever you click on this tools here, so as you can see here, tools below, there is a option available, highlighted board. Here you have to select the particular microcontroller board whatever you're using. In this project we are using Arduino Nano, so just click on this board and come here. So as you can see, different boards available. Select the Arduino Nano. So I have selected Arduino Nano. Once the board has been selected, you can compile the code in this system itself. No need to connect the Arduino Nano microcontroller to your system or laptop in order to compile. So as you can see, port is not highlighted because I have not connected the board here. Just board is it is showing whichever I selected here, Arduino Nano, and port is not connected. Now we'll compile the code. So in order to compile the code, below the file there is a write mark available. So that is in order to compile the code. Just click on it, is highlighted as you can see, compiling sketch. So now the code is compiling. So once the compilation is done, so it shows done compiling. So if any error is available means it will, like any error is there means it will be shown below. So this code doesn't have any error, it is showing done compiling. So once the compilation has been done, so now you connect the Arduino Nano microcontroller to your system or laptop. After that you click on tools again. So as you can see, Arduino Nano, it is a board has selected, and port it is highlighted now because I have connected Arduino Nano. It is showing serial ports COM3. So it is need not to be COM3, whatever the COM1, 2, 3, 4, whatever is show when after connecting the Arduino Nano. So just you have to select this one. So after that you have to upload code to this Arduino Nano. So for in order to upload, after the compilation button, there's a right arrow mark is available. That is in order to upload code to your particular microcontroller. So just click on this upload. So the code will be uploaded to your Arduino Nano microcontroller, and the project will work like how I have written the logic in this program, smart irrigation project. So you can you can see temperature and humidity values in the serial monitor. Similarly, you can see moisture is low or high, and moisture values also you can see in the serial monitor. Similarly, water level, whatever the water level sensor is detecting values, analog values, those also you can see, and whether the water level is high or low, that will be printed in serial monitor. Similarly, whenever water level is low, water pump will be turned on by this system, that is the controller. If the water level is high means automatically pump will be turned off. So in this way, this project will work. So thank you for watching the video. Thank you.